I've known teachers that have come in and said, I just teach them and they have to learn. That's what teaching is. No, that's not what teaching is. I mean, that may be what it looked like back in the day. We are called to be there for those students, and to be able to do that is not a 9-to-5.
Room done! Room done! Room done!
So, curiosity is, and I love this quote, it's like the seed for creativity. I know we know a lot about Albert Einstein, we've got him up on the wall, but Albert Einstein said this, who can read this for me? Who can read this? Thank you, Andrew.
I have no special talent. I'm only
passionately
curious.
I want them to love learning. I want them to be fearless. I want them to tackle things because life isn't smooth, as we know. Life is bumpy. And I want them to look at those challenges and be able to say, no, I can work through this. I can do this.
Ready? One, two.
I think it was 2005, 2006. I was sitting exactly where you guys were. I was in Ms. Dunbar's fifth grade class, and I remember doing all of those fun stuff.
It's taking that curiosity, that creativity, it's taking all the skills that we're working on here in fifth grade and culminating in a better life for them, a better future, a better attitude toward adversity, and a willingness to work through it and not give up until they figured it out. Teachers would laugh at me, but it's love.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the doctor is in the house. Is you ready for science? Yeah?
Yeah!
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 It's when you make that connection with the student and you know you've meant something to them, whether it's they just got a math problem or they just realized what they were doing was a bad decision, or teachers call it the aha moment, and we get that warm, fuzzy feeling. But it's I love my students. And because of that, I know I'm where I'm supposed to be.